Unless you're gonna pitch in here, keep a distance.
Excuse me.
Looking to earn some caps? I could use a hand here if you're all done talking, you know.
I could probably help for a few caps extra.
I was gonna give you something anyway. 75 caps for your time?
What do you need help with?
The pump isn't in top shape, but it should at least start. There must be some leaky connections flooding me out. Think you could fix them? The leaks will be underwater. Look for bubbles, and you should find them.
Pro gamer right here.
Ah, there it is. That's a ticket. You do. Do the honors. Hit that switch on the end of the pump. Maybe if I close off this intake, I can get enough pressure.
Just listen to her go.
Wait a second, did you hear that? What? Let's do this.
Thank you.
That's it. Unless you're gonna pitch in here, keep a distance.
Excuse me.
Looking to earn some caps? I could use a hand here if you're all done gawking, you know.
I could probably help for a few caps extra.
I was gonna give you something anyway.
What do you need help with?
The pump isn't in top shape, but it should at least start. There must be some leaky connections flooding. The leaks will be underwater.
Twin City Radio, and I'm, this is me, Travis. Anyway. Here's Sheldon Allman with Crawl Out Through the Fallout. Nice overall, but no, that rhymes.
Hey there.
What do you want? We don't need any more trouble around here.
If I told you I'm with the Minutemen, would you still want to shoot me?
You're with the Minutemen? I didn't really think you fellas still existed. We sent word with one of them passing traitors. But honestly, I never expected anything to come of it. Most people don't put much stock in the Minutemen these days. After Quincy. Bad business, that.
I didn't expect to get lectured by the people I came to help.
I didn't mean to give offense. Damn glad you're here. No mistake. There's a raider gang that's been giving us trouble for weeks. Stealing food and supplies. Threatening to kill us all if we don't pony up. We know where they're coming from. But we can't go up against a gang like that.
Will you be willing to join the Minutemen once I've dealt with those raiders?
We'll certainly give it a good long think. People have gotten used to not being able to count on you folks. That's not going to change overnight.
That was, Wynonie Harris. So, this radio station here, we don't really make any caps. And, there are, well, some people help me stay in the air. People like this. Swatters. Own a piece of Diamond City history, and then beat people to death with it. Here's some Betty Hutton, if you were waiting to hear it. I mean, whether you were or not, hear it. Betty Hutton. Oh, that butcher Pete. Just doing butcher sorts of things, I guess. If anyone's family has recently been butchered, I am sorry for what I just said. Okay, that was Roy Brown. Here's a thing. A sort of note, I guess, from a sponsor here in Diamond City, and I'll,
Come back!
Just read it.
Worse.
The Colonial Pep House wants to remind everyone that you are not welcome there. Upper state of disgrace.
Games with me, huh?
coming.
Sweet.
Think you can hide?
Oh.
doesn't love some Louis Jordan? Am I right? I am. Because Louis Jordan rules. So, there's a bit of, news. Well, more of a, you know, a rumor, really. Someone, I'm not sure who, I guess. I mean, probably doesn't matter who. Anyway, someone saw, well, I guess they think, maybe they saw a person in a vault suit. I mean, coming out of Vault 111. It's the Vault 111 part that's weird, I guess, right? I mean, it's not like no one's ever seen a vault suit before. I just... Oh, man. Well, anyway, you get the idea, I guess. So let's go back to the music. So, how about Billy Ward and the Dominoes? This one, I mean, it's a... I'll just play it.
Shit! Lost him.
Thank you.
you get it.
Hey.
Who's there?
Hey.
That was the 5 stars. All 5 of them. Get it? Because it's, well, it's funny? Sort of? No. No. Okay. Not really. Here's a thing. A sort of note, I guess, from a sponsor here in Diamond City. And I'll just read it. Commonwealth Weaponry. It's a dangerous world out there. Protect yourself. Protect your family. Rocket 69 is next. And, I mean, you don't hear them singing about the other 68 rockets, which kind of makes me think...
paranoid. There ain't nothing here. What the?
I sometimes do. City Radio. Next is some Cole Porter.
You find those raiders?
Yeah, I kicked their asses for you.
No kidding? That's the best piece of news we've had around here for a good long time. So we've been talking. We decided if you came through for us, we'd join up with the Minutemen again. If we want things to get better, we've got to start helping each other. So, we're in. You can count on us if you need help down the line. Thanks again, friend.
Any chair?
The sight's been real exhausting lately. Got aches and pains. Even when I'm lying down. I know it's odd asking for a fitted chair in this day and age, but it really helped me out, kid.
Sure. Glad to help.
Thank you.
Thank you. Let's trade.
Looking forward to that chair.
I'm afraid I'm not much use in a fight anymore. But back in the day, folks used to call me Murphy the Mad Woman.
Mama Murphy.
Let me get in my chair and we can talk. You remind me of a young man I used to know. Never looking for trouble, but always finding it.
Mama Murphy.
You need the sight? It's telling me Mentax will give us the right high for another insight into your destiny.
So it's Mentats this time?
They're good. More of a chem for scientists and tech types. But who's to say old Mama Murphy ain't a closet genius?
There you go.
Ah, that's it. I can feel the sight opening up. You're looking for a man. He can help you. But he ain't gonna be the man you expect. He's somewhere deep and dark, surrounded by folks with nothing but cruel intentions. But there's an echo. Something in the past that can help you. When you meet the fat man and the angry woman, tell them to remember the quarry and Lily June on the rocks, and they'll let you and your friend pass. Don't mind me, kid. The chems are just acting up a bit. I'll be fine. Eventually.
Mama Murphy.
Tired. The sight takes a toll on you.
Another good one. Another good one from Betty Hutton. So, this radio station, we don't really make any caps. And there are, well, some people help me stay in the air. People like this.
You know that settlement you sent me to help?
Commonwealth.
They've decided to join the Minutemen.
That's great news. I knew you were the right person for the job. By the way, you should have one of these flare guns. You can use it to signal for help from any nearby Minutemen.
Yep. Yeah,
not much use yet, but once we have more allied settlements, you'll have help whenever you need it. So, there's something I need to ask you. I don't think I ever told you what happened to the Minutemen. How I ended up as the last one.
I'm listening.
Have you heard of the Quincy Massacre?
What was it?
I thought everyone in the Commonwealth knew about that by now. Where the Minutemen betrayed each other, and the people they were supposed to protect. I was with Colonel Hollis's group. A mercenary group called the Gunners was attacking Quincy. The people there called for the Minutemen to help. We were the only ones that came. The other groups, they just turned their backs on us and the folks in Quincy. Only a few of us got out alive. Colonel Hollis was dead, so I ended up in charge of the survivors. We never found a safe place to settle. One disaster after another. You saw how it ended in Concord?
I know how it feels to be the last survivor.
Yeah, I guess you do. That's why I'm talking to you. I can't rebuild the Minutemen, but I think you can.
Why can't you lead the Minutemen?
That's not who I am. I can get my men through a firefight. I can defend a perimeter against all odds. But that's not going to be enough to bring the Minutemen back from the brink. We need someone who can bring the whole Commonwealth together in a common cause. And I think you've got it in you to be that leader.
What makes you think I can do this?
You saved us in Concord. There wasn't anything in it for you. You had your own problems to deal with, but you did it anyway. That kind of selflessness has been in mighty short supply around here for quite a while.
Okay. I'll do it.
Good. Good. Welcome aboard. I feel like this is a whole new start for the Minutemen, and the Commonwealth, too. Don't worry. I'll be right beside you all the way, General.
Why are you calling me General?
The leader of the Minutemen has always held the rank of General. Our last leader was General Becker. After he died back in 82, nobody could agree on who should take his place. The one good thing about being the last Minuteman is there's no one to argue with me when I say you're the new general. Now it's your job to make it more than an empty title.
I've gotten word about a settlement that's being threatened by raiders. I'll mark it on your map. We'll find out what they need. We could use more settlements supporting our cause.
Having a place to sleep will improve everyone's spirit. What we need now is a reliable source of clean water.
What do you mean?
Like a well. Then we don't have to keep drinking the river water. That stuff's not good for you.
Nice.
I hope you enjoyed that last song. Okay.
Got it.
And now, a word or several from our sponsors. Stop in for a drink at the Dugout Inn. The stories are free, but the moonshine will... ...will cost you. Ask for Vadim Bobrov. Hey, how about a song by, the Hate Spots, maybe? This one is, it's called It's All Over But the Crying.
if I redirect the flow to a team.
Hey there.
That's a ticket. You do the honors. Hit that switch on the end of the pump. That's done. Just listen to her go. There it is. Meyer lurks. I guess I shouldn't be surprised that started him up. Anyway, I still got some tinkering to do on this thing. Shouldn't be too hard now, though. Thanks for pitching in. Here's a little something before you clear out.
Diamond City Radio, and I'm, you know, it's me, Travis. Anyway, Elton Britt is next with a song that, well, frankly, it sounds very irresponsible for several reasons. Here's Uranium Fever.
Automated message repeating. This is Scribe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARCS, Ferrum 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge Police Station.
Welcome to Grey Garden, darling. This is the Commonwealth's first and only hydroponics facility. Run entirely by
Scribe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission.
There's not even one person here?
That's right, darling. We are entirely self-sufficient, with no need for human guidance. You see, there are two kinds of robots here. The worker drones carry out labor and maintenance. We supervisors, that is myself, green and brown, possess sophisticated cognition processes. We are capable of complex analysis and decision-making, a testament to the genius of our creator, Dr. Edward Gray.
Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies.
Only a madman would think that artificial intelligence could replace human intuition and experience.
You misunderstand him, darling. He wanted only to know what a machine was truly capable of. Robotics and artificial intelligence were our creator's great passions, rivaled only by his love of television. Perhaps you've noticed that I possess a rather singular personality. As do the other supervisors.
We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge.
television.
Great. Just when I thought I was finally free of television.
A few other things you should know. Talk to Green if you need supplies. If it's caps you require, Brown might have a few odd jobs. There's one other thing. A question, really. Tell me, darling. What do you think of the water around here? We're requesting support
or evac from our position. It's awful.
Isn't it, though? Pressure's down, radiation is up. Why, it's practically toxic. Just think what it must be doing. This will never do. I don't mean to impose, darling, but perhaps you could lend us a hand. Our
unit has sustained casualties. What's in it for me?
Trust me, darling. I can make it worth your while. Most of our water comes from the old Western plant, south of here. Such an eyesore. Be a dear and pay a visit, See what you can do. Maybe tidy up the place. It must be filthy. If you can get it working again, I'm sure I can come up with something for you.
What's that then? I should bring me some new crops for seed, and there'll be caps that will market to. Off you go, then.
Supervisor Brown.
Caps for new fruits. That's the way.
Have you looked into our little water problem, darling?
Authorization ARCS, Pharaoh, 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge Police Station. Automated message repeated. This is Scribe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARCS, Pharaoh, 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge Police Station. Automated message repeated. This is Scribe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARCS, Pharaoh, 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge Police Station. Automated message repeating. This is Scribe Halo, Reconnaissance Squad Gladius, to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARCS, Pharaoh, 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge Police Station. Automated message repeating. This is Scribe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARCS, Pharaoh, 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies. We're requesting support or evac from our position at Cambridge Police Station. Automated message repeating. This is Scribe Halen of Reconnaissance Squad Gladius to any unit in transmission range. Authorization ARCS, Pharaoh, 9-5. Our unit has sustained casualties, and we're running low on supplies.
I don't think we're alone. We appreciate the assistance, civilian, but what's your business here?
I'm just trying to survive out here, like everyone else.
The way you charged in and engaged those ferals, I find that a bit difficult to believe. Are you from a local settlement?
I'm from Vault 111.
You're a vault dweller? Most people wouldn't admit to such a thing. I appreciate your honesty. If I appear suspicious, it's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth, we've been constantly under fire. If you want to continue pitching in, we could use an extra gun on our side.
That all depends. How much are you paying?
We need allies, not opportunistic mercenaries. I have no inclination to pay for your services.
I want to help, but I don't like the secrecy. Who are you, really?
Very well. I'm Paladin Dance, Brotherhood of Steel. Over there is Scribe Halen and Knight Reese. We're on recon duty, but I'm down a man and our supplies are running low. I've been trying to send a distress call to my superiors, but the signal's too weak to reach them.
Sir, if I may...
Proceed, Halen.
I've modified the radio tower on the roof of the police station, but I'm afraid it just isn't enough. What we need is something that will boost the signal.
Our target is ArcJet Systems, and it contains the technology we need, the deep-range transmitter. We infiltrate the facility, secure the transmitter, and bring it back here. So what do you say? You willing to lend the Brotherhood of Steel a hand?
No time to waste. Let's get moving.
Outstanding. Halen, take Reese inside and bind his wounds.
Yes, sir.
Reese, once you're on your feet, I want you to make certain the perimeter is secure.
I'm on it.
All right, civilian. Time to prove your worth. Head into the police station and resupply yourself. Let me know when you're ready. Let's move out.
All right, big guy. Let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Excuse me, Paladin Dance?
You ready to move out?
Ready.
Outstanding. Follow me, and try not to lag behind.
So you gonna patch me up or what?
I don't know. Your prognosis looks pretty grim. Might be more humane to just take you out back and shoot you.
Excuse me.
You're all heart, Doc.
Just
why are you standing around here like there's nothing
to do? So I can get these bandages
Paladin
on.
Dances.
Jet is a short hike to the west. If we take this road, we should be able to avoid the larger packs of ferals infesting Cambridge. Traveling this far from the police station is a risk, but getting that transmitter up and running needs to be our top priority. If it was up to me, I'd relocate my team. But Scribe Halen detected some disturbing energy readings in the area that need to be investigated. We don't know much about them, except that they're short-lived and broadcast on a frequency only attainable with a high level of technology. We're concerned that whoever or whatever is creating those energy readings might be a potential threat. So it's our job to investigate. first team's mission was a huge success. We came back with crates full of pre-war artifacts and historical documents. The second wasn't so fortunate. Shortly after they arrived, we lost contact with them. They haven't been heard from since. As far as my team goes, we've lost four good men to this godforsaken wasteland. We've been a target from the moment we arrived. But despite our setbacks, I don't intend to give up and head home, or end up missing.
Dance?
Listen up. We do this clean and quiet. No heroics and by the book. Understood?
Understood.
Outstanding. Remember, our primary target is the deep range transmitter. Stay focused and check your fire. I don't want to be hit by stray bullets. corporations like this that put the last nail in the coffin for mankind. They exploited technology for their own gains, pocketing the cash and ignoring the damage they've done. Look at these wrecks. It appears as though the facility's automated security's already been dealt with. Appears as though the facility's...
Paladin.
Look at these wrecks. It appears as though the facility's automated security's already been dealt with.
Good. Less security to worry about.
Negative. There's nothing good about it. Look at the evidence. There isn't a single spent ammunition casing or drop of blood in sight. These robots were assaulted by Institute synths.
Synth? Isn't that the same as robot?
They're an abuse of technology created by the Institute. Abominations meant to improve upon humanity. It's unacceptable. They simply can't be allowed to exist.
What's the Institute?
They're a group of scientists who went underground when the Great War started. Spent the last few decades littering the Commonwealth with their technological nightmares.
I'll be on the lookout.
Roger that. Let's move out. This place is a mess, but I still see a few pieces of salvage that the Brotherhood might be interested in. After we're done here, we'll have to mark this place for sweep and retrieve. Looks like a dead end. See if you can find a way to get that door open. I'm gonna reconnoiter the area. Show them how the Brotherhood does it.
Is someone present?
By order of the Institute, you must be destroyed. Hostile sensor reading detected. Scanners must be malfunctioning.
You hear that?
We've got company! Assessment, you must die.
Got it.
The damn synths have compromised most of the facility. Remain vigilant. We've got turrets ahead. Hold on.
Come on!
Corps is ahead. Should be our final stop. Watch your footing. Looks like the power's out in this section. Look at this place. Scribes would have a field day in here. The transmitter should be in the control room at the top of the core. But it looks like the elevators are dead. We'll have to keep heading down for now and find a way to get the facility's power back online. There has to be a power backup system somewhere. Scout the maintenance area off of the main chamber. I'll remain here and watch our backs.
Perfect.
I'm sure he took shop class. Oh, look, he's reading the science mags. How cute.
Har, har, har. Shop class. Let's see them make this in shop class. My marvel of engineering. The finest in weaponized refuse acceleration. My beauty. My junk jet. They'll see. The engineers with their suits and fancy degrees. Come Monday morning. I'll see.
Thank you.
this.
Engine core power restored. Thermal engine fueled. Prime. Standing by for your command. Command accepted. Commencing 5-second countdown. 5, 3, 2, 1. Engine firing.
That's it.
Engine core power restored. Thermal engine fueled, primed, and standing by for your Where did you go?
Looks like we've secured the core. Let's head up to the control room.
Soil sensor reading detected. Hello?
They're in the control room.
Thank you.
about?
Smoother? I thought we did fine.
We're both alive and the transmitter's been secure. There's no need to scrutinize the details.
I thought we worked well as a team.
Agreed. It's a refreshing change to work with a civilian who can follow orders properly. That being said, I believe we have two important matters to discuss. First and foremost, if you'll hand me the deep-range transmitter, I'd like to compensate you for your assistance during this operation. I think you'll find this weapon useful. It's my own personal modification of the standard Brotherhood laser rifle. May it serve you well in battle.
Don't you need to keep it?
This isn't the only weapon at my disposal. Brotherhood soldiers always carry a backup. Now, as far as the second matter goes, I wanted to make you a proposal. We had a lot thrown at us back there. Our op could have ended in disaster, but you kept your cool and handled it like a soldier. There's no doubt in my mind that you've got what it takes. The way I see it, you've got a choice. You could spend the rest of your life wandering from place to place, trading an extra hand for a meager reward. Or you could join the Brotherhood of Steel and make your mark on the world. So, what do you say?
What would be expected of me if I joined?
You'd be under my command. And I'd expect you to follow orders. No more mercenary work. This is the real thing. You'd have access to advanced military weapons, as well as your own personal suit of power armor. Most importantly, you'd have the Brotherhood at your back, ready to spill its own blood to keep you alive. Offer still stands. Can we count on you?
I'd be honored to join.
That's what I wanted to hear. Meet me back at the police station, and we'll discuss the details.
Paladin Dance. Glad to see you alive and well, sir.
Are we in luck, sir?
Mission accomplished. We have the transmitter.
Finally! Some good news for a change. Nice work, sir.
I didn't do it alone. Aelin, Reese, it's time to welcome our newest recruit to the recon team. He shows a lot of promise. And with the proper guidance, I think he has the potential of becoming one of the best.
Thanks. I promise not...
You don't have to prove anything else to me. Getting that transmitter was enough.
So you decided to stay, huh? I expected you to take your payment and run.
Let's just hug this out and get it over with. What do you say?
You can play it however you want, tough guy. It's gonna take a lot more than completing one mission to impress me.
Reese, that's enough. Like it or not, you're going to have to learn to work together. And you need to understand what it means to be a part of the Brotherhood. We're not soldiers of fortune. We're an army, and we've dedicated our lives to uphold a strict code of ethics. If you intend to stay within our ranks, you need to obey our tenets without question.
Are you gonna teach me this code of ethics?
If you are paying attention in ArcJet, you should have learned some of it already. The rest will become apparent as you spend time with your fellow soldiers. Now, since I know you're eager to get started, I'll get right to the point. I only ask for two things from anyone under my command. Honesty, and respect. You fall in line, you stay in line. I give you an order, and you follow it. It's as simple as that. Now, before I release you to Halen and Reese for your assignments, there's one last order of business. From this moment forward, I'm granting you the rank of Initiate. This is only a training rank. I'm not permitted to grant ranks any higher than that.
Fair enough.
Outstanding, soldier.
Ad Victorium, Initiate.
He doesn't even know what that means, Halen.
Ad Victorium means to victory. In our eyes, defeat is unacceptable, because we're fighting for the future of mankind. Our rallying cry is more powerful than any weapon you could ever carry. Remember that. Now, I need you to report to Halen or Reese for your next assignment. Dismissed, soldier.
Scribe Halen?
Reese still giving you the cold shoulder.
Why does he hate me?
He doesn't hate you. Reese bleeds Brotherhood. It's all he cares about. It's his family. It's his whole life. If anything else comes into the picture and gets in the way, he shoves it aside.
Is there something between the two of you?
When I first joined up, Reese is the one who sponsored me. He took me under his wing, showed me the ropes. I thought there was a little more between us, so I asked him if he cared about me that way. He told me the Brotherhood of Steel was all that he cared about, and there was no room for anything else in his life. We never spoke about it again. Look, I need to get back to things. If you're worried about Reese, just keep doing what you're doing. He'll come around soon enough. So, are you ready to take on your first assignment?
I'm not sure.
Don't worry. I wouldn't send you after anything I didn't think you could handle. We just have a lot of work to do out here. And you're a welcome set of extra hands. Take whatever time you need to prepare yourself. And let me know when you're ready to go.
Halen?
Good. You're back. Are you ready to take on your first assignment?
Ready.
Great. Let me explain what I need you to do. One of the Brotherhood's most important duties is the recovery and preservation of technology that was lost when the bombs fell. I have a list of locations that contain artifacts we need you to recover in order to have them cataloged and studied by our scribes. Here, this should cover all the information you'll need to find your first artifact. Good luck, and be careful. We still have so much to learn about the mistakes we made in the past, and how to prevent us from repeating them.
Hey.
All right, out with it. What's your game?
Game? What do you mean?
I can usually size people up at a glance, but you... you're different. And it's bugging the heck out of me. You're not the military type. You're a loner. So I can't figure out why you're sticking around. You got what you wanted, so why don't you hit the road?
The Brotherhood might be the best chance I'll ever have to find my son.
Well, as far as reasons go, that's a pretty good one. Look, I'm gonna cut you some slack because Dance trusts you. But if you step out of line and put any of my brothers or sisters in danger, I'll make sure you regret it. So, ready for your assignment, hero?
Ready.
Then listen up. Like it or not, one of our most important duties is to keep the Commonwealth clear of the trash. I'm talking about mutants, ghouls, synths. The abominations the damn eggheads caused when they started playing with their toys. This op is simple. I'm gonna send you to a target, and you're gonna terminate everything that calls it home. All the details you need are right here. Don't come back until the job's done.
Tex Beneke, folks. If you're the kind of person who is tired of living in Diamond City, and you maybe want an adventure or something, I guess you have a new option. The settlement of Sanctuary has, I guess, been founded to the northwest there. Good luck to them with, you know, the whole surviving thing. And in other news, it sounds like maybe the... not other news, it's actually the same news. The Minutemen were involved in this.
You got your
the
orders.
The Minutemen.
Move like you got a purpose.
I thought they were kind of done for. It sounds kind of crazy. And if it were real, it would be super dangerous, I bet. This is Johnny Mercer singing about personality. If you got it, you should appreciate it, because it's not necessarily common. Johnny Mercer. Such a positive guy, that Bing Crosby. This radio station, here, we don't really make any caps. And there are, some people help me stay in the air. People like this. Choice Chops wants you to know we have meat. Just meat. Stop asking if we have anything else. Elton Britt is next with a song that, well, frankly, it sounds very irresponsible for several reasons. Here's Uranium Fever. Connie Allen there with Rocket 69. If you're the kind of person who is tired of living in Diamond City and you maybe want an adventure or something, I guess you have a new option. The settlement of Sanctuary has, I guess, been founded to the northwest there. Good luck to them with, you know, the whole surrounding. And in other news, it sounds like maybe the... not other news, it's actually the same news. The Minutemen were involved in this. That's the Minutemen. I thought they were kind of done for. It sounds kind of crazy, if you ask me. And if it were real, it would be super dangerous, I bet. There's more of Butcher Pete. And, well... here it is. song was, it was, Hold On. It was by Three Sons. And, oh, never mind. If you're the kind of person who is, tired of living in Diamond City, and you maybe want a adventure or something, I guess you have a new option. The settlement of Sanctuary has, I guess, been founded to the north there. Good luck to them with, you know, the whole ceremony. And in other news, it sounds like maybe not other news, it's actually the same news. The Minutemen were involved in this. That's the Minutemen. I thought they were kind of done for. It sounds kind of crazy, if you ask me. And if it were real, it would be super dangerous, I bet.
When someone named Big Maybell says there's a whole lot of shaking going on, you can probably believe. I mean, it's fair to say that's probably accurate. She's tremulous.